Guided Meditation for Transcendence, Day 92. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. It's so good to have you here. I am so happy to see you again. And today is Day 92. My God, we nearly done it. 100 Days Meditation Challenge. It's been over 3 months where we've been meditating together every single day. This is absolutely awesome, brilliant, amazing. Any adjective you want to put in here, you can put it in the comments below. Share your adjectives today. And I'm thrilled to be meditating with you again today to share your beautiful energies across the world. And let's start today with a little bit of gratitude to our supporters on Patreon. Thank you so much for your donations. It means a lot. I'm very grateful for it. And to welcome our new listeners, don't feel obliged to go to day one today. You can join us here. You'll get the full instructions, don't worry. And later today or tomorrow, you can go back to day one of those meditations. In the meantime, let's start. As always, we start with a nice quote. And today's quote is by Viktor Frankl in his book, Man's Search for Meaning. Viktor Frankl was a survivor of the Holocaust, and he wrote a brilliant book on how different people dealt with being in those death camps, which is very, very strong, very, very powerful stuff, very troubling to read also, but remarkable also, and a lot of beauty in all this darkness. And a quote that I want to read you today says, "Everything can be taken from a man, but one thing, the last of the human freedoms, to choose one's attitude in any given set of circumstances, to choose one's own way." Now, this guy wrote this when everything was taken from him, his family, his dignity, his name was replaced by a number on his arm. You can imagine all the atrocities that you want, and yet he finds this light in his last, as he says, the last of the human freedoms, to choose one's attitude in any given set of circumstances, to choose one's own way. We've been talking about this concept of responsibility, and two words, ability to respond to an event, that an outcome doesn't depend on the event, but the way we respond to it, or as Epictetus says, our opinion of that event. I really like this quote. I hope you liked it too. Let me know in the comments how you interpret it, how you can use it in your everyday life, and how this resonates with you too. And on that note, let's start with today's meditation by sitting nice and comfortably on our chair or on our meditation pillow, or if you're very courageous, directly on the floor. Sitting nice and tall, nice and straight, nice and aligned. Remember this analogy of a string pulling you up from the top of your head, chin in, chest out, and let's start with some nice deep breaths in through the nose, nice and gentle, nice and soft, nice and deep. And out through the mouth with a nice sigh of release, of relief, release, relief. The same thing, actually, we're releasing the air from the balloon, and that creates a relief that creates an opportunity to release tension in the body and to relax more and more. And again, inhaling through the nose, down from the belly, up to the chest, and up. And when we're full, release the balloon of air. No effort, no action in the exhalation, just an extra dose of relaxation. One more time, in through the nose. And on that exhale, gently close your eyes, sorry. In a moment or two, you will be greeted, you'll be introduced to a vibration, a sound. You'll put your attention, your focus, as gently and as effortlessly as possible on that vibration. That vibration will be used as our guide, so put it on the foreground of your mind. And our guide to what, you may ask? Well, our guide to transcendence, our guide beyond our own ego, beyond our understandings of life, of the universe around us, and of our lives inside of us, within, as well as our concepts, of simple concepts of time and space, eliminating the past and the future to enable us to be fully present here and now, doing this deep trance-guided meditation today together. And when you catch yourself thinking, Don't try to eliminate the thought. Don't get rid of the thought. Don't judge your thought and don't judge yourself for thinking that thought. Simply go back to the vibration, putting it on the foreground, on the center stage of your inner space. When the sound, the vibration fades out, reproduce it in your own mind, keeping it alive for a few extra moments. may now let go of the vibration. The meditation session is over. Don't cling on to the vibration, really let it go. Whenever you're ready, take a nice deep breath in through the nose. And on the exhalation, open your eyes. Take some time here to get reacquainted with the sensations in your body, starting with your extremities, with your toes and your fingers, your hands, your feet. And also get reacquainted with the space that you're in, the environment around you. Notice what's familiar, what's new. Notice any colors, lights, shadows, shapes, textures. Notice also some sounds and smells, and really start to noticing what they are coming back from this guided meditation, this deep trance meditation. And that's it for me today. I will leave you in peace to get back to it and then to go back to your daily activities. Thank you again for joining me on this meditation. I've really enjoyed it. And if you have also, please press the like button, subscribe to the channel if you've not done so already. And I will see you tomorrow for day 93 out of 100 days meditation challenge. Take care. See you soon. Bye-bye.